Users love real-time data, whether it's keeping an eye on stocks, following a team's score, or tracking a driver's approach. These experiences engage users and keep them coming back for more. It's the kind of thing GraphQL subscriptions were made for. These operations subscribe us to the data that's constantly changing, opening a channel between client and server for instant live updates. Creating these kinds of experiences can become difficult when the data that powers them is sprawled across different services and APIs and maintained by different teams. But with Apollo GraphOS, we can switch on federated subscriptions, a powerful feature that enables clients to subscribe to data that lives across any number of data sources. So with a single operation, users get updates on their driver's changing location, along with all the data that doesn't change. GraphOS reduces the complexity of working with this data, allowing clients to fetch everything they need from a single source. And so, with even the most complex data implementations, this means our teams can stop wrangling endpoints and instead focus on building responsive, powerful, real-time experiences. Let's look a little bit closer at this example. I've got a few services in my graph. One shows me all the details about my order, its status, who's picking it up, the time that it was placed, estimated time of arrival, all those details that we'd want to know about our order. Another one of my services has information about the driver, what their name is, the car they drive, how long they've been driving for us. And then we've got a third service. It's all about reviews relating to our delivery. And each of these services is managed by a different team. They're each written in a different language. They've each got their own stack of technologies powering them. So if we were to do this without the power of GraphOS, bringing all of our data sources together in one queryable layer, we would probably have to first make a request to our order service. What are the details about this order that I'm waiting for? And from that order, we could take the ID of the driver who's responsible for it. We could reach out to our driver's service and say, hey, give me some more details about them. Once we get that, we could also send a request to the review service and say, what can you tell me about this driver and their past performance? And receiving all of that data, that could take some time. And then we have to stitch it together to give our client, our downstream consumers, a cohesive experience. We can actually centralize all of that data here in GraphOS in a single operation. Let me show you. Here's our subscription operation. Right now, it's subscribing to the driver's status for a particular order. And you can see here that we're including a couple of different static fields, like the driver's name and their overall rating. But we're also getting data that changes a little bit more frequently. The driver's coordinates, their latitude and longitude as they make their way towards us. So when we submit this operation in Explorer, we can see that our subscription is listening for changes. It's waiting to detect anything that's different about our coordinate value. That's the part that we're subscribing to. And we can take a look at the query plan here and see how many steps along the way the router is going to take to coordinate this data about our driver. We can see that it's going to reach out to the driver's service, getting the driver's name, to the review service to get their overall rating. And it's going to combine that data with the coordinates and how they're changing from our order service. The router can manage the requests to each of our services at the same time. So there's no manual work involved to fetch data from one place and then use it to determine how we fetch data from another. The router has the intelligence to put together the plan for how it can fetch data in parallel and what needs to be fetched first in case there are any dependencies. In the process, we just get the data that we asked for. We don't have this huge bloated REST API response that we have to comb through and cut apart. We just get the driver's name, their overall rating, and their coordinates. Nothing more, nothing less. So really, GraphQL and live data go hand in hand. And with subscriptions, the router's got you covered, whether you're using WebSockets or HTTP callbacks to bring your experiences to life. If you want to learn more about subscriptions, GraphOS, or just get in touch with us, check out the links.
Up and down.
Wherever Johnny puts them, you'll find them.